thief starts running from a policeman's house at 5 a.m. at a speed 60 kilometers per hour. The policeman realizes that something has happened or some theft has happened at, let's say, 8 a.m. So he starts chasing, right? Suppose he is aware about the direction of the thief or in which direction the thief has gone. Okay. So the policeman starts chasing the thief at a speed 80 kilometers per hour at 8 a.m. So the policeman starts at 8 a.m. The thief has already started at 5 a.m. The question is, at what time and at what distance the policeman catches the thief? At what time and at what distance the policeman catches the thief? Now look at the situation at 5 a.m. What is the situation at 5 a.m.? This is the house of policeman, and the thief starts running from here at a speed 60 kilometers per hour. And what is the situation at 8 a.m.? This is still the house of policeman, but the thief has already traveled 3 hours, 5 a.m. to 8 a.m. So in 3 hours, thief would be here, policeman would be here. And how much will be this distance? Whatever is the distance traveled by thief in 3 hours at a speed 60 kilometers per hour. So this distance has to be 180 kilometers. So this becomes a situation of a relative speed. The thief is running at a speed 60 kilometers per hour. Policeman is running at a speed 80 kilometers per hour. Because it says the policeman has started chasing. Chasing, that means he is running in the same direction. So right now it's a question of relative speed. So the time taken will be equal to the distance 180 divided by. Now they're running in the same direction. Will the meeting be possible? Yes, because the faster one is behind. So 180 divided by relative speed, that is same direction ke liye, we have to subtract. So it is 80 minus 60. So it is 180 divided by 20. So time is equal to 9 hours. That means the thief will be caught after 9 hours. After 9 hours? 9 hours from what? 5 a.m. or 8 a.m.? See, the policeman has started chasing at 8 a.m. After that, he has taken 9 hours. So, the time or the moment will be 8 a.m. plus 9 hours. So that will become 8 a.m. plus 9 hours. That will become 17, that is 5 p.m. So, thief will be caught at 5 p.m. Alright? Now, the second part of the question is, at what distance from the policeman's house the thief will be caught? The policeman has started at 8 a.m. He has traveled for 9 hours. The speed of policeman is 80 kilometers per hour. So the distance is 80 into 9, which is 720 kilometers. Right? Policeman has traveled for 9 hours and at a speed of 80. Whatever distance he has traveled to catch the thief only. So the total distance will be 80 into 9, which is 720 kilometers. You can calculate with the help of the speed of thief as well. The only thing is, thief has started at 5 a.m. So the total time for which the thief has run is 5 a.m. to 5 p.m., which is 12 hours. So if you multiply 12 hours into 60 km per hour, you will get the same distance, obviously. Right? Both of them, the total distance traveled by both of them has to be the same. So the distance is 70 kilometers, time is the moment is 5 p.m., duration is 9 hours. A 500 meter long train crosses a man sitting in a 300 meter long slower train in 45 seconds. The speed of slower train is 72 kilometers per hour. find the speed of faster train. Read the question carefully. 500 meter long train crosses a man sitting in a 300 meter long slower train in 45 seconds. The speed of slower train is 72 kilometers per hour. Find the speed of the faster train. Here, we do not have to consider the crossing of two trains. Right? Please read the question very carefully. It says the long train, the longer train or the faster train, this is the faster train, crosses a man sitting in a 300 meter long train. Now understand, if a man is sitting in the train, then his speed would be same as that of the train. Okay? Now here one more thing is required, that the speed of the train is 72 kilometers per hour in same direction. In same direction. So both the trains are in same direction. Okay. In same direction. Now find the speed of the fast train. So now what is the situation that we need to understand? There is a train. Let's say this is the fast one. The length of this train is 500 meters. Speed is unknown. Let's say it is S. Okay. Then there is slower train. The length of this is 300 meters. Alright. And there is a man sitting in this train. Now here, this length doesn't matter. This train also doesn't matter. We only have to consider the man. The speed of the man is 72 kilometers per hour. And for that matter, it is 20 meters per second. So basically, the man is moving at a speed 20 meters per second and this train has to cross this man. So this is the situation of train and man, not of two trains. Right? So the time taken will be equal to only the length of this train divided by speed of the train plus speed of the man. It is in the same direction, so it is S minus speed of the man. Just understand this again. The man is sitting in the train. The significance of that is the speed of the man will be same as the speed of the slow train. That's the only requirement of the second train. So this 300 meter is not required at all. Only the speed is required. Right? So this train crosses this man. Whether he's sitting in the train or is traveling on his own is the same thing in this situation. Okay. Now time is given 45. Length is given 500. Speed of the train we have to find. Speed of the man is 20. Alright. So we get S minus 20 is equal to 500 by 45. This will become 100 by 9. Let it be for some time. So S is equal to 100 by 9 plus 20, which is 180 plus 100, 280 by 9 meter per second. So this is the speed of the train. This is 280 by 9 meter per second. Okay. Suppose we have to find in kilometers per hour. So it will become 280 by 9 into, we are converting from meter per second to kilometers per hour. So multiply by 18 by 5. So 9 twos are and 5 56 times. So it becomes 112 kilometers per hour.